It's a dangerous love affair. Stop. Victories within the mouth. Almost dead, don't give up now. Only thing that's on my mind is who won this town tonight.
Stop.
Who won this town tonight?
We'd like to welcome you to this edition of the Tiger Football Report. John McElroy joined by head coach Barry Lunny of the Bentonville Tigers. Well, Coach Lunny, first things in order, congratulations as the Bentonville Tigers now advance to their third consecutive state title game with a hard-fought 28-21 victory over the Fort Smith Southside Rebels. Well, Coach, great ball game Friday night. Your thoughts on the ball game?
Well, it was. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. As you mentioned, our third trip to the state finals in the last 3 years. And I don't want anybody to take it for granted. This is pretty special, and as it is for Fayetteville as well, and really unique. I think it's the first time in the large classification history that three straight years the same teams are in the finals. That speaks, volumes for both programs at this time. We're both running through with some good athletes, obviously, and the coaching that they're doing, and I think my staff is doing has meshed well, and both teams are programs are in a situation right now where we're coming out at the end of the season facing each other, and so we don't take those things for granted. We know that these are very special times, and looking at the game, preparation for the game, one of the key things, John, was that our ability to be able to kind of stop Ike Jackson, dual threat, outstanding running. And a very good arm, and I think we did a good job of taking him out after the initial series. They came out and moved the ball down the field and scored using a lot of the clock, which is what I knew they were going to try to do, and I was worried about that. We responded and scored, but after that we really pretty well settled in and took his running out of the equation and did a good job overall against the run. His arm a little bit different and got about 175-80 yards passing and hit a couple touchdown passes, which kept them in the game.
Well, it was certainly another great high school football game Friday night, and when we return from this commercial break, we'll go out to Tiger Stadium to see how it all unfolded. First half highlights are next right here on the Tiger Football Report.
When your car is in need of a facelift in Bentonville, the number one place for auto and glass repair is Bob Morey's Auto Body. From repairing a simple fender bender to a total reconstruction, our highly skilled team of trained professionals will spare no detail in restoring your vehicle just in time for that next tailgate. When their work is complete, you'll have a vehicle that's worth a little showing off. And while you're there, don't forget to stop by Tiger Tales, your one-stop shop for Bentonville apparel and accessories. We carry high-quality name-brand shirts, jackets, hats, flags, headbands, and pretty much everything else you can think of. So there's only one place to go when getting yourself and your vehicle ready for that next game at Tiger Stadium. Bob Morey's Auto Body and Tiger Tales, a very proud sponsor of your Bentonville Tigers.
All right, Coach. Well, they say when you're playing on Thanksgiving weekend, you've had a pretty good season.
It's a good sign playing on Thanksgiving weekend. You're absolutely right. We won the toss, deferred, chose to put our defense on the field, and good sky kick. We didn't kick it deep. Had pretty good coverage there. They were big and physical. Did a good job of their blocking schemes, and there's what scares you right there. Had everybody covered, and guy's got some, 6'3", he's 185 or 90 pounds, and he's a load once you get started. We jammed it inside and bounced it out, but that's his athleticism. We made some adjustments on that. We had put a little bit of a defensive, different look in, and trying to bounce everything outside, and we did, but we just weren't. We were kind of getting cut off and weren't able to make the plays early on, and we kind of switched some things up and did a much better job of it from then on.
So Southside takes an early 7-0 lead, so we'll get a first look at your offense right here.
Yeah, and they sky kicked, and we took the ball, went out of bounds. We took it at the point. Well, this was big for us to, you know, to be able to go back. They took a lot of time off the clock, scored, and to be able to go down and score again was really very important for us to do that.
Great catch right there.
Throw, nice throw and catch. You know, John, we didn't need them to score, and then us have to punt and then get the ball back again and take a lot of time off the clock. That would have played right in their hands. But being able to come back and score, little play action, which pulled the linebacker and the backside safety, held them for just a little bit and run what we call a glance route. Nate was in, beautiful throw and catch. And we, you know, the Tigers came back and answered, and that was extremely important at that point for us to come back and answer that touchdown, the initial touchdown.
Boy, a lot of time ran off the clock, two possessions, and almost
all
the quarter's
all
gone,
yeah. Wasn't it? Yeah, that's kind of unrare nowadays with the passing offenses and the clock stopping as much as it does because of incomplete passes and first down. Kick, good cut. Oh, we overran it. You know, that's what happens sometimes when a guy fumbles the ball, then everybody starts running, trying to get down there, and they end up overrunning it. Good job hemming in.
And here's where you can see you really started to make some adjustments with what they were doing in that second possession.
Yeah, I think so, too. And we get in a situation, we let them get a little third down and complete a third down pass on us. We had them two good defensive run stops and then let them hit a third down. There's Whitfield, very good solid back. They've still given us some problems. You know, that zone read, there's so many different options out of it. You've got to be very disciplined and get off your blocks. There's his reading, pulls up the throw. Come on, come on. Hobby breakdown. Did we come up with this one or did they get it? I can't remember. Just bouncing around. We did, yeah. Good job. I guess that was Justin Fair, I think it might have been.
I think that's who we called.
Yeah. Come back. Terrace, good. Hard run in there. Come on.
Boy, this was a great play by Terrace Wallace. Carried him about 5 to 10 yards.
Covering up the ball. They're trying to strip it out. Oh, man. We had the open, the receiver open on that, and just, you know, I think that was their linebacker came off and just gave us a little bit. Didn't have enough time. Didn't have enough time to complete the pass or have a chance to complete. There he is. We're bouncing outside. Stay outside. Good job right there. Is that Nate? Yep. Coming down from the safety position. Got to get some pressure. Run a screen. We got it covered up pretty good. Great job right there playing the screen.
Well, that was important, as I think they scored 3 times last week on screen passes.
Yes, yes. They did a really nice job last week with that play. Our guys, the defense coach did a good job of clamping that down, as we say. Good hard run right there. A little play action. Just about had that. I thought it was a little bit of interference, but there's another nice kick. We're going to get it covered down inside the 10-yard line. Good job. Giving them a long field to work with was, you know, as always, it's extremely important. Any game, professional, peewee, doesn't matter. Field position is a huge key to the outcome of the game. Good job on quarterback draw. Force them to punt again. And I think this is the one right before half.
We get
a chance of good and makes the first guy miss, gets the outside, get a few blocks, peel back blocks. Boom, there's one, another one. Gets us down in shape. And even on this drive, we had good position, but we had some penalties overcome. We had a couple fourth down issues that we overcome. I think we had a fourth and about 14 that Jimmy Jackson, we got barely 15, and wasn't that a fourth down play, I believe, Cody Scroggins. A really nice throw and catch right before half and gets us up 14-7 going in at halftime.
Well, that's why you like to defer right there. You go
get the ball
ahead score, you get the ball coming back.
Absolutely, and you know, that was a really an outstanding sequence of events right there, because we got in some situation. We had fourth down. We were in a situation too long for a field goal, and yet we needed to have an opportunity to, you know, do something with the ball. Let's go ahead and take a shot, that was just a really good call. Good throw, good execution. And like I said, it gives us about 20 seconds to go in the half. We get out of the half with going up, a lot of momentum. you know, from the offensive score. Feel like we've made the adjustments defensively, and knowing we're going to get the ball to come out to start the second half was a really good, you know, good feeling in the dressing room, and our coaches did a good job of making some adjustments with our guys at halftime, and get ready for the second half.
Well, there you have it. The Tigers up 14-7 at halftime. We'll be back in just a moment with the second half highlights right here on the Tiger Football Report.
Oh my gosh, Garrett, I told you to watch out, now look what happened. We're gonna miss kickoff. My dad sat there and told me before we left that you're irresponsible, and now he's right.
You think your dad's gonna be mad? My dad's gonna kill me.
What are we gonna do?
Don't worry, cause like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
I got this, guys.
With a football player?
With a cheerleader.
Changing back?
No, that's how I really like you.
I don't want any part of that.
State Farm agents are there when you need them.
In Bentonville, call State Farm agent Dwayne Trischel.
I'm Gann Nunley, reminding you Nunley Chevrolet in Bentonville is where you need to buy your next vehicle. Just listen to what our satisfied customers have to say.
I would recommend Nunley to anyone looking for a new car. I love my new Cruise.
I never purchased a car where they catered to me like Nunley.
All I can say is that my repeat business will go to Nunley Chevrolet.
Now is the time to make the best offer on a new Chevrolet, and let us add you to our list of satisfied customers. Saving money is simple at Nunley Chevrolet on Mobley Lane in Bentonville.
Okay, we're back here on the Tiger Football Report. Second half beginning here, Coach, and you're going to get the ball.
They sky kicked. Caleb Haney did a good job stepping up and getting it, and here we go. Run a little outside play there. Good blocking on the outside. Nice route. Good throw. Reese and
Nate Nighting.
Was that Nate? Okay,
yeah.
I have a hard time with those numbers as well. I know you must have. And there's, I'm not sure he wasn't down to start with. And a good job with, was that Jimmy getting on the ball, loose ball? Come on, guys, the whistle blew a long time ago. They come down, they throw just a little bubble. Good blocking on the outside. Get Cody in there for, good play. Excellent play. They were taking their outside backer and kind of playing him in between the help on the run and the pass, and he cheated down enough that it's kind of a thing that the coaches look at and say, hey, we just got to make a decision which way they want to go, and so they decided to throw it that time to our slot back. Cody had a really good night, 2 touchdowns. He's a talented young receiver.
Well, now you can breathe a little easier, but of course, fortunately, Southside, there's not going to be any quitting those guys. But up 21-7, you're feeling a little better.
Yeah, no doubt. And I think that we felt defensively that we made some adjustments that were going to help us out. That takes them out a little bit of their running game that they really want to do. Good kick. Coverage here. Nice job, Garrett Kaufman.
That is a great tackle. That's
broke through the front line and made the nice tackle. I'm going to wrap up. I'm not too worried about it. Now, that's where they broke through. We actually had a little blitz on with our linebacker and ran by him. And they hit us and creased us there, which kind of gave him the field position, getting a little bit better field position.
Again, here you see that zone read.
Zone read. Yeah. Good job right there. I don't know if that was John that was there first, and then Chris Mizell came up, really popped him. You know, you're going to carry the ball. You got to make him pay a little bit. Oh man, we had another interception and dropped it. We've dropped too many of those, you know, lately. There's a good play right there. Nice run by Terrace upside. Our guys are coming off the ball. Oh, here we go. Get caught from behind and lose the football. This is where we put our defense in a bind. You know, we had a chance offensively, ran around midfield to move. And, you know, the worst case scenario, you punt. And we put our defense out on the field. In bad situations, and this is what you got to do. Defensively, you got to be able to go out when a break goes against you, a turnover, and it's not always about playing great defense when you got them backed up on their end, but it's, you know, what do you do after a sudden change? And we got out and we held them on fourth down. Coming across, we had a chance to to get the first down, and they did a good job of just stripping the ball. We just got to be better protection, and then we put the defense back out again on our end of the field. And you're asking a whole bunch with a talented team. You're asking a whole bunch out of the defense to continue to go out and make plays. Chris Mizell,
yeah,
I think.
Good open field tackle.
Yeah, a little play action pass, and they throw a nice play. Just better play than us. We got out of position a little bit, and he threw a great ball and made a great catch.
Yeah, only the second passing touchdown allowed by the defense this year.
Yeah. Caleb decided to take that a little bit, get us a few yards back. Did a nice job of taking care of the ball. So we got to come back to, you know, on this end of it and make some things happen. Good job, Terrace. Just keep on coming to the outside.
Well, there's something you see right there. Terrace knowing he's got to
take care of the football. Yeah. They've been really trying to strip the football, and then we knew that, and he had to. Good job lowering that shoulder. That's one of the better runs right there he had during the night. They got 170 something yards, 40 some odd carries. We just put it on his shoulders, and he really responded. There's Jimmy, I think. Didn't get a good spot out of that because he knocked the official back, and he lost sight of where the ball was. Come on. Nice
so
job.
So strong.
They're catching us from the backside. I tell you, they were doing some things on the backside. Stopped us on fourth down. That was very, very displeasing there from our end of it. And it was a backside guy. And we've got to take care of that. We got to get better at that. They run a little sprint out and up. And Hags didn't bite on it. Came in and made a really nice interception. Good job.
Yeah, Austin seen that route a few times.
Yeah, no doubt. Yeah, right. Did a real nice job. Good come back. Good stiff arm running over him. Boy, I tell you what, that's a really good run. Really nice run. Good crowd for Thanksgiving weekend. I'm very pleased with that. A little pump and go, and they actually held Jimmy on it, but he made just a great adjustment to the ball. I'm telling you, it's good to have him back full speed. We missed him being full speed with that wrist injury. Get down on, was this a third down or fourth down? I can't remember. I think it was third.
Third down.
Yeah. We'd tried to run our inside zone a couple times, and they were just really making it really difficult. We had a timeout, decided to just go ahead and hit it on the outside. And I think Jack Krause and I'm not sure who the tight end was at the time, Bugus maybe, but. Well, they did a really nice job blocking on the edge. It was real important. Those guys do a good job and kind of seal everything back inside, and then we were able to get outside and score.
Okay, so now the Rebels have to get two touchdowns.
28-14 right now.
Four minutes. So.
And good read, good play right there. John Donald and the rest of the guys there. Clay Wallace, a bunch of them got there. We had everything covered. It was checked down, and we really played that well. Got the ball back. Good hard running right there. Just stayed in bounds, keep that clock going. And we got backside again, stopped this, I think. Was that another fourth down series? Oh, it was third down. And that was where we got the ball. We had an unsportsmanlike, which is uncalled for on our end of it. And we had it down their end, and that cost us. Even though we had stopped them on fourth down, we lost 15 yards of field position, which was really not good. I'm not happy with us getting in that situation. They're at the good job of pressure.
Nick Fernandez
who's still got a little bit of a bad wheel, but is playing, just got to play. Get the pressure, come on, get the pressure. And we gave him some seams here. I'm not displeased with their defense at all. I mean, they just, again, we put them in bad situations. They played lights out. Most of the time, we just were a little soft and giving them some zone, not letting them, you know, get up the big pass, which is what you don't want to do this late in the game. But you know, we got to guard the sidelines a little bit more, not let them get in the middle of the field. And they went down the field to their credit and scored very fast. Didn't use much clock at all, and. Got to be a little bit better at that. You know, coach is never satisfied totally, but the defense really played a well of a game. They really did. When you're playing somebody that's got the dual threat, like the running game with two or three backs, including the quarterback, that are very explosive, And then the guys got the arm like they do, and the receivers. It puts a lot of pressure on your defense, and I think that's the most points we've given up with our first group in maybe 2 years. And so you can't be totally displeased with 21 points. In today's offenses and, right. and the high-powered offenses, our defense has had a remarkable, remarkable year, and extremely pleased with them. And good to get out and win, I promise you that.
Well, there you have it. The Tigers advance to next week's state title game with a 28-21 victory over the Fort Smith Southside Rebels. We'll be back in just a moment to preview next week's state title game right here on the Tiger Football Report.
Welcome to a new approach to women's health care in Northwest Arkansas, one that's designed to bring you peace of mind. LifeSpring Women's Health Care, located in Bentonville and led by a team of local, highly trained physicians, LifeSpring is here to provide you with the highest quality of health care using the latest, most advanced techniques and technology. At the same time, we emphasize one-to-one care in an attentive, supportive environment. We don't just focus on your health. Your comfort, quality of life, and peace of mind are all part of our primary mission. LifeSpring Women's Healthcare, inspiring changes in women's healthcare.
Hey, we're back here on the Tiger Football Report. Well, Coach, the Tigers advance to the state championship game for the third consecutive year, and this will be the sixth meeting now in three seasons with the Fayetteville Bulldogs. Preview next week's state title game for us.
Well, it should be a great game. Obviously, if you look at the history of the two teams, it's turned into one of the outstanding rivalries in the state of Arkansas, and it should be. I mean, two schools, very close, same league, and two outstanding programs, and kids probably know each other from camps and summer ball and those types of things, and they do. And so, we played them out here this year in a championship environment. It was for the conference championship game, and obviously it came down to the end. And I won't be surprised if it does again. This is a Fayetteville team that I will remind everybody. You know, they've got us ranked number one, but right now because they had lost an early season game or two, but a non-conference season. But this is the team that, by every publication, Hootons and AP and Arkansas Preps and, you know, Three Sigma, you name them, they were preseason number one in everybody's polls, and rightfully so. They returned 16 starters off a state championship team. You're returning three guys that are BCS Division I football players that have already committed to the University of Arkansas. They've got a kicker who should be, that didn't even play last year, that's kicked a 52 or 54 right. yard field goal against us and hit the game winning field goal last night, kicked three field goals against North Little Rock, I believe it was. And then you got Jordan Dennis, who'll be a Division I. This is a team that, by everybody's expectations, would be in this game, and they've lived up to their end of it. So even though they've, the people got us ranked number one because we haven't lost a game yet, but this is the team that sports writers and everybody alike picked to win it again because of the great people they had coming back and the number of starters they had come back, and it starts with Austin Allen, who's having a fabulous year. So it'll take a great game from us, to be able to have a chance to win the game. There's no doubt. We have a very fine line of margin for error. We have a very thin margin of error against somebody like that. And I'm confident our coaches will do a good job, as they've always have, of getting our kids ready to play. Getting to play in the championship game just doesn't happen very often. And this group of seniors, this happens for third time for their career. So we got a great week of preparation ahead of us, and looking forward to the trip and the game Friday, Saturday night, I guess it is. And we'll get an extra day this week to get ready for this passing attack they got. But remember too that they ran the ball pretty good this out here with Gahagans back. So again, another tremendous challenge for our defense.
Well, Coach, let me say first of all, good luck as the team travels to Little Rock this week to battle for the 7A state championship.
Thanks, John. Appreciate it.
And we'd like to thank you always, the viewers, for joining us here each week where we take you inside of Bentonville Tiger football. So long, everyone.
Hey, great job. That's a way to finish that off. Hey! Hey, let's go. That is an excellent job. We made it tough on ourselves. We put the defense offensively. We put them in a hole way too many times. They did a great job in the circumstances we did. It's the football team. It's the football team. But it right there, number one, we got away with it tonight, okay? Give them credit. They're going to compete. They had nothing to lose. They let it loose and played tough. We persevered and won the football game. It says a whole bunch about this football team, man. It says a whole bunch about this football team. The main thing is we got a big week next week. The main thing is we're going to Little Rock. The main thing is we're not just going to Little Rock. Huh? What are we going to do?
Win!
What are we going to do?
Win!
We're going back. We're going back. Get a chance to do it again. Not many people ever get a chance to go back again. You understand that? West again, 3 years in a row. Call it up. Garrett, where you at, buddy? Let's go.
Okay, go.
See you around.
Here comes Garrett Thompson here.
Taylor, what is your profession?
Oh.
Get up, get going.
Let's go.
Let's go, buddy.
We don't think. What you think?
What?